Martin Luther King Jr., I Have a Dream. 50 years ago, a great American, in whose symbolic shadow we stand today, signed the Emancipation Proclamation. This momentous decree came as a great beacon light of hope to millions of Negro slaves who had been seared in the flames of withering injustice. It came as a joyous daybreak to end the long night of their captivity. But 100 years later, a Negro still is not free. 100 years later, the life of a Negro is still sadly crippled by the manacles of segregation and the chains of discrimination. 100 years later, a Negro lives on a lonely island of poverty in the midst of a vast ocean of material prosperity. 100 years later, a Negro is still languishing in the corners of American society and finds himself in exile in his own land. So we have come here today to dramatize a shameful condition. In a sense, we have come to our nation's capital to cash a check. When the architects of our republic wrote the magnificent words of the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence, they were signing a promissory note to which every American was to fall heir. This note was a promise that all men, yes, black men and also white men, will be guaranteed the unalienable rights of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.